Once they're outside of the Pier's docking compartment, Kononenko, who is again designated as EV1 or extravehicular crew member number one for today's spacewalk, he'll be wearing the Orlan suit with the red stripes, and Prokopyev, wearing the suit with the blue stripes as EV2, will retrieve a foot restraint from that is currently housed on the large diameter section of the Zvezda service module, and a foot restraint adapter that will be used to be installed on one of two so-called Strela booms. Strela, which is the Russian word for arrow, these are telescoping booms that extend to a length of some 49 feet and will be used by Kononenko to be swung around, essentially, first to the Zarya module, where a second Strela boom is located. He will then dismount from the Strela 1 boom. He'll plant his foot into a foot restraint onto the Strela 2 boom that is housed on the Zarya module, and that will enable him to get to the work site on the habitation module of the Soyuz vehicle that is mated to the Rosviet module on the Earth-facing side of the International Space Station, and will then access the Soyuz leak area that you see in this graphic, where he will then begin to use a series of knives and cutting tools to cut away through about a 10-inch section of multi-layer insulation blankets and the micrometeoroid orbital debris shield that's underneath those blankets to get to the hull of the habitation module, correspondent with the area where the hole was detected back in August and which was a few hours later sealed to stop the reduction of pressure inside the International Space Station. Once Kononenko and Prokopyev have arrived at the inspection site on the habitation module of the Soyuz vehicle, again Kononenko will use a series of tools to cut about a 10-inch swath of the multi-layer insulation away right there, as you see, from near that series of insignias that signify the word Soyuz that you see, along with the insignia from Roscosmos, RSC Energia, and the Russian flag. The work that will be done by Kononenko, again, is strictly designed not to repair anything, but to gather data and some samples of any of the sealant material that would have extruded on the outside hull of the Soyuz vehicle to return to Earth for analysis by Russian specialists back on the ground. The rectangular box that you see right in front of Kononenko's helmet, that's a sample container that the samples will be placed in for return to Earth. Once the work is done to collect those samples, there will be an insulation blanket that will be installed over the area where the cutting will have taken place to peel back that small section of insulation and the micrometeoroid orbital debris shield. That thermal blanket will be installed and secured in place with a series of clips so that that area will not be exposed to the heat of reentry when that vehicle comes home on December 19th.